Of course, there's been a lot of discussion about the Keystone XL Pipeline, and this has been an issue that has been defined as much by geography as anything else. It's been under study for quite some time. The president has pushed this back to the State Department, which has to make the ultimate decision. They've gone through study after study, and there are a lot of people pushing for this to happen. And that includes, by the way, unions who are really wanting to see this because it means a lot of jobs. And the question is whether it's going to happen or not. Well, somebody's trying to actually speed that process a little bit. And that's our next guest. Congressman Lee Terry is a Republican from the 2nd District in Nebraska and joins us. Congressman, welcome to the show this morning.
Thank you.
So you've introduced legislation that would, what, somehow accelerate the process?
Yeah, it accelerates it because, well, it allows Congress by the vote to just deem the permit approved, and we take it out of the president's hands. So that's how we move the project forward.
Now, the idea is that it needs State Department approval because of an executive order signed by President Bush, right? Which means that anything like this which crosses borders has to be approved by the State Department.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Traditionally, even back in the early 70s, Congress deemed the Alaskan pipeline permitted, just like my bill. In fact, I used that that bill as the model for the one I introduced, and that we'll mark up in committee next week.
Well, so how does it work to have a congressional piece of legislation override an executive order?
Well, that feels good, actually, but the reality is that in the White House, State Department, they're torn between two friends, as you kind of set up this interview, and between the environmentalists and labor, and therefore it's stuck in politics. This permit was filed somewhere around 1,650 days ago, and just to put that in context, World War II was won in 1,300 days, and Lewis and Clark expedition was 1,100 days. So it's time to move this forward.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is even 60. What did you say? 1,600 and how many?
50.
Okay, so it was about 100 days before President Obama even took office.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
So give us a sense then of. I mean, obviously, you're from Nebraska, and this is the state that is most affected, or at least the one that supposedly had the most to lose possibly from an environmental standpoint, correct?
Oh, yeah. It was crossing a sensitive area. The original route was crossing a sensitive ecosystem called the Sandhills.
Mm-hmm. And that was, there have been several studies on that. You feel that people in Nebraska are fully cognizant and are fine with this, and they're ready and willing and able to move this forward in Nebraska?
Not all, but the vast majority, a big majority. And I'm going to rely on the science in making the decision here. There's been multiple environmental studies on this route, including a new one on the new route in Nebraska, and all have said that there's a negligible impact to the environment. So I'm going to go with science over rhetoric.
Is there a way that you can get Democrats on board? And I ask this question because they don't have to be to get through the House, but obviously through the Senate they do. But in a way, it would seem to me, if you wanted to position it this way, it would actually make it easier for the White House to have the Congress move this forward, although a lot of Democrats in the Senate probably would not be really popular in some states, you know, but there might be enough moderate Democrats who would benefit from this, who would say this would be nice, because then we take the onus off of the White House and off of the Secretary of State. Or do they want the president to make the decision and then they don't have to figure out, they don't have to make a vote on it?
Well, that I like that logic. I think this is a good way for the president. I assume he knows that this has to be done at some point in time, and then to let Congress go ahead and make the decision means that he doesn't have to choose between friends, and he can actually blame us. But I don't know if he adheres to that.
Are there enough Democrats? And I know it's the Senate. The question is, I guess, are there enough Democrats in the Senate who could go along with that?
Absolutely.
I think so.
Absolutely. You know, Senator Hoeven had an amendment to the budget a couple weeks ago.
Is your fellow senator from Nebraska?
No, he's North Dakota.
Oh, North Dakota, that's right.
North Dakota.
Right.
And it passed with 62 votes and 15 or 16 Democrats. So it's the placebo vote on Keystone in the Senate actually is filibuster proof.
Hmm.
So I have a great deal of confidence from that vote. And, of course, we've had several votes in the House And we've had overwhelming Democratic support. So I feel very confident this is going to be a large bipartisan vote.
You had one to open the pipeline or something like what you're proposing, or what was that vote?
Yeah, we had one to force the president to to actually make a decision. Then we had another vote on giving the power over to the Federal Electrical Commission, or FERC. And both those passed overwhelmingly with Democratic support. Of course, only one of them went through the Senate.
All right. So you have proposed this. Is it going to go through the process, or are you just going to do a vote on it pretty soon? What's the next step?
Yeah, we're going regular order in the House on this bill.
So we had hearings?
A hearing yesterday.
Oh, the hearings yesterday.
Yeah, we had a hearing yesterday. Went really well. Then we'll have a subcommittee and full committee markup next week. We'll see it on the floor before our Memorial weekend break.
And the State Department supposedly has to make a decision by May, or that was the latest announcement. Is that correct?
Well, if you go through their timetable, but they keep setting up new timetables. And so it'll be further than later than May. And I worry that when they finish all of their hearings and comment periods, which they have multiple, that they will ask or recommend an additional study.
And is there a point at which the company and Canada can decide, and if they do decide, is there a drop dead for them at saying, have they given a deadline, says, look, if you don't make a decision by this particular date, we're going to make alternative plans?
Well, they have signaled that, but they haven't set a date. They haven't given us a drop-dead date, but they're losing their second or third construction season. And China very much wants that oil, and so they're buying up oil leases, and there's more discussion about a eastern pipeline running from Alberta over to the west coast of Canada to put it on takers and send it to China.
All right. Well, we'll see how it progresses. Congressman, we appreciate you spending time with us this morning. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim.